Good morning and welcome to the Jeromesville United Methodist Church. You will find our announcements on the back of your bulletin, and there I have a few more to mention today as well. First off, last week Peg Figley announced her retirement and her move back to Jeromesville into her parents' home right next to the Kerrs. So if you have a chance and you see her, please make sure to offer good wishes for her retirement and move back to this area. Secondly, on Tuesday of this week, we will have a fair planning meeting at 7 p.m. here at the church. I will be sending an email out and a reminder about that earlier or later today. This Wednesday at 8 p.m., there will be a trustees meeting here at the church. Okay, my next announcement, I received two this morning from Sue Tibbs that I will be reading from my phone. The first is, it says, thank you to everyone who has sent congratulations, cards, and gifts to Brian in honor of his graduation. Due to the circumstances with Estelle and our family being his caregivers, we have decided not to hold a graduation party. Brian very much appreciates the love and support of his church family now and throughout the years. He also asks that you continue to support Hebrews Ministries and through it, the ministry of Rahab as they do the hard work God has led them to do. Her second announcement, Estelle Tibbs has been diagnosed with a form of lung cancer that is now systemic. Due to his condition and frailty, they are not able to offer a treatment such as chemo. For pain management, they are planning to do 5 treatments of radiation on the 2 tumors they have pinpointed, and then the plan will be to bring him home on hospice care with the Tibbs as caregivers, if possible. Your prayers for all of us through this difficult time are much appreciated. Sue Tibbs. Pastor Sue sent out an email earlier this week giving some information about our services and how we enter and about masks. She sent an update to that this morning just before the service. So masks are not mandatory as they were originally said to be in the first email. So please take a look at that data, and if you have any questions, please feel free to give her a call. Okay. Now, I would like for all of you to stand, please, and we will do the passing of the peace from our pews, so give a wave to all your neighbors, and then we will join in the call to worship. Okay. Our call to worship today. Our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
O Lord, we pray.
You are the Prince of Peace.
You are Almighty God. Hallelujah. Amen.
You may be seated.
Thank you. Good to see everyone today. I have some joys and concerns. We'll start with the concerns. This is a joy, actually. Bill Hickson is home, but he's still on the mend, so we need to pray for him. Estelle Tibbs, as you heard Sherry talk about, all that whole family. Dale Abels, Derek Smith, our nation, and the spread of COVID-19, plus all other concerns. I have a thank you note from Brian Tibbs. It's really wonderful. Dear church family, thank you so much for the many things you've done for me, from the sign, cross, cup, and services this year, to helping raise me to be who I am today. Being a part of your family has given me a wide group in which I can trust and love to serve in return. I hope to continue this bond for as long as I come here and beyond, if possible. Like that. Thank you, Brian. Well, you haven't been able to get to the bulletin board to see what's over there, so I thought I would share. We have the Hillsdale High School Honor Roll for the fourth 9 weeks. All A's, seniors, Briar Funk and Brian Tibbs, juniors, Olivia Traylor, sophomores, Lacey Fickus, freshmen, Grace Myers, and the A's and B's, seniors, Jared Leifer, sophomores, Jager Jolliffe, Michaela Krishbaum, freshmen, Bailey Baldner-Wise, Emily McGovern, and Marissa Young. It was a tough term. So thank you, kids. You did a great job. Also, campus news, spring semester dean's list, Sarah Leifer, Ohio University, Sydney Long, Ohio Dominican University. And if you saw this on Facebook, I've got to share this. Ohio Funeral Directors Association recognizes Don E. Fickus for 50 years for faithfully serving the people of your community as a licensed funeral professional, 2020. Isn't that great? I saw Don, he said, well, actually, it's like 52, and I'm old. Yeah. So, let us go to the Lord in silent prayer. Gracious and loving God, we are thankful for each joy that has been shared this morning, plus other joys that were not mentioned. Without your grace and love, there would be no joys to share. You have worked through each person with whom we celebrate. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. The positive things in life help us navigate through difficult and challenging times. As you have blessed us with countless joys, both large and small, you also bless and care for those in pain. By your strong and mighty power, we pray for healing and wholeness for all people and all situations. Now more than ever, great physician, we need you. We believe in you with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength. Yes, Lord Jesus, all honor and glory belongs to you. O Holy Spirit, continue to guide this congregation in our efforts to bring us once again into your house of worship. All of this we pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, who taught us all to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
If you would please rise. And join me in the affirmation of faith, which today is the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From hence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. Today's epistle lesson comes from Romans chapter 12, verses 9 through 13, as written by Paul. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor, serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with God's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. This ends the reading.
Thank you.
I heard some humming out there. Great. I invite you to stand, if you're able, for the gospel reading. Matthew 10, verses 40 through 42. Jesus told his disciples, "He who receives you receives me, and he who receives me receives the one who sent me. Anyone who receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And anyone who receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And if anyone gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones because he is my disciple, I tell you the truth, he will certainly not lose his reward." This is the word of the Lord. Please be seated. Several years ago, I purchased a Westlow Cross Cycle, aka stationary bike. A Walmart employee put this heavy box in the trunk of my car. On the way home, I'm like, how am I gonna get this out of the trunk? Well, I actually had a good idea. After I ripped open the box, which in itself takes about 10 minutes, I took each part and took it in the house. Well, that was the easy part. Then I read the instructions. I wanted to put this thing together, and for one who knows next to nothing about assembling anything, the 9-step process was daunting, even with diagrams. Step 1, turn the rear stabilizer, number 2, in the diagram, so that the slot faces downward, and insert the rear stabilizer into the frame, number 1 in the diagram. Attach the rear stabilizer to number 2 with 4 M6 by 10 millimeter machine screws. Lucky for me, the parts were included and they had a nice chart that identified them. Step 2, turn the front stabilizer, number 5, so that the square holes are facing away from the saddle bracket on the frame, number 1. Attach the front stabilizer, number 5, with 2 M8 by 40 millimeter carriage bolts, 2 M8 curved washers, and 2 M8 lock nuts. I believe it took at least 2 hours. 2 hours. And it was a good thing I was by myself. But I got it together and there were no parts left over. So it was a success. I don't want to ever do something like that again. There are next to impossible instructions to follow. And then there's easy to accomplish instructions. Perusing our new cookbook, I found the perfect recipe for my talent, and it's in here, boiling water. Yeah, submitted by someone in the church, a gal with whom I share cooking skills, Patty Traylor. Yeah, so, it's true. Ingredients, 1 cup water, more if needed, any temperature under 212 degrees. Directions, place water into pan, cover with lid. Place on burner and wait patiently. If patience grows thin, check to see if burner is lit. Do not watch closely, as a watched pot never boils. As a precaution, you should put local fire department on standby. When it is boiling, use as needed. I just love that. Love that. In Matthew 10, Jesus called his 12 disciples to him and gave them authority to drive out evil spirits and to heal every disease and sickness. And Jesus sent them out with the following instructions. Well, the Lord's instructions start at verse 5 and finish at verse 42. He told them where to go, what to do, and how they should act. I invite you to read those instructions. Not as technical as assembling a bike, though not as simple as boiling water. We're going to look at the last three verses. Anyone who welcomes you, Jesus said, welcomes me. And anyone who welcomes me also welcomes the one who sent me. As messengers of Christ, the disciples shared the good news of salvation. As they traveled, they stayed at the homes of the residents. So even if the food was terrible and the bed was lumpy, they were to stay in that place until they moved to the next town. If their host welcomed these men and their message, they also welcomed Jesus. And it stands to reason that when folks welcomed Jesus, they invited God into their lives. There's a four-way partnership between God, Jesus, the disciples, and the hosts. God, of course, initiated the partnership by sending Jesus. Jesus then sends the disciples. The disciples take the third step by going out, and those who welcome the disciples take the final step and providing support. This is the verse that I want to concentrate on. And if anyone gives even a cup of cold water to one of these little ones, because he is my disciple, I tell you the truth, he will certainly not lose his reward. Now, technically, the disciples were to receive the cup of cold water. However, I want us as individuals and as a church to offer a cup of cold water to anyone who is thirsty. And I'm talking more than just a literal cup of water. How much we love God can be measured by how well we treat others. Jesus' example of giving a cup of cold water to a thirsty child is a good model of unselfish service. A child usually cannot or will not return a favor, and that's okay, because God notices every good deed we do or don't do as if he were the one receiving it. A cup of cold water. Such a little thing, yet a huge thing. Offering a cup of cold water, no big deal, right? I mean, we do that all the time. Well, consider the little things you do on a daily basis. Probably don't even think about it. Opening the door for someone as they enter or leave a building. Walking through the line at a potluck, fixing a tray for someone who is not able to navigate the process and not eating any of it before it gets there, and making room for a car to squeeze in front of you, especially when there's a lot of traffic as they're coming out of a parking lot. I'm more than happy to do that, except you're on a four-lane road, there's a sign that says, left lane closed ahead. And you have plenty of time to know this and get over. And there's always one person who speeds past everybody. The rest of us are waiting patiently. And then he tries to cut in front of me. Ain't gonna happen. I mean, I'll pull up real close to the car in front of me, and he can just stay there. How Christian of me, huh? Well, yeah, no way. Little things matter. A friend gives you a small gift saying, I saw this and thought of you. The small, inexpensive gift is not a big deal for the giver. It's simply a gesture of kindness. To the recipient, it is huge. She has kept it all these years, moving from one parsonage to another. I have a few things, and a couple of these I've had forever. You know, we say, I'll do it when I get around to it. I have around to it. It says do it on it.
Yeah.
Do you have one of those?
And
I have this little dog, a little about what, 2-3 inches big. And I think I've had this thing since high school, but it always has a place on a bookshelf in the house. And then I have this little girl who's reading a book, and she always lives on the windowsill next to the kitchen sink. I mean, it's just one of those things. And another one. A ship in a bottle. Anybody got one of those? Yeah. There's two more that are really symbolic of important things in my life. The first is a stingray bike ornament. And this is special because thanks to Uncle Willis, who started the Susie Chidley Bike Project, I was able to purchase a bike like this. And I still have the paperwork. It's really cool. Finally, we grew up on Fair Street, and at the end of Fair Street was the community park and the duck pond. And every winter, I would skate as many days as I could. So one year, my younger sister gave me these skates. Yeah, the ceramic, of course. I mean, I love these things. I think it's supposed to be used as a planter, but I cleaned it out yesterday and it had dog hair in it. So, because it always lives in the living room on the floor next to my TV. Little things matter. A little squirt of hand sanitizer can save a life. A little prayer for a hurting friend makes a big difference. The sprinkling of a little water at baptism has huge implications. Jesus uses little things, small things, seemingly insignificant things to make huge differences in the lives of people. The gift of a cup of cold water is powerful. When it is offered in Jesus' name, is shared to honor him, and is given to bless others and thank Jesus for his love and grace. So, what does your cup of cold water symbolize? More than a cup of cold water. The small, everyday gifts of love you share with others? It doesn't have to be a nine-step process. It can be as simple as boiling water. Because there are a lot of children of God, of all ages, in our community who are thirsty for the living water, Jesus. Offer them Christ in small ways, for little things matter. Amen. Go now in the peace and the love of Jesus Christ. And may God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
Nice job.
I love your medleys.
Thanks. You try and pick popular hymns.